Hello, you malingering worms. It's Jim Sterling here with a game I am quite excited to be playing for the first time in, God, what's it been, 3 years? This is Enslaved, Odyssey to the West, which Namco Bandai has recently re-released on the PlayStation Network and brought to Steam under the auspice of the, what is it, the Ultimate Edition? Or the Superb Lovely Boy Edition? Something like that. It's one of those two. This is Enslaved Odyssey to the West, a game that when I originally reviewed for Destructoid in, I believe, 2010, I gave like a 9.5 to, because I think this game is superb. Many people will tell you about, you know, oh, it's flawed, it's got these flaws because it's flawed, look at all the flaws, there are so many flaws, you could stack it from the floor to the floor on the second floor of your house. But screw them, this game is awesome. Looks gorgeous, although I'm having to play it not at my 2560 resolution, which I like to do, because I can. But it should hopefully still look awesome. It's a beautiful looking game. It's got a great story, great characters. We're just going to dive right into it. Please, let's do that. Just whack it on normal. So this is Enslaved, Odyssey to the West. I'm pleased to be playing it again. It's been too long. This was a good excuse to do it. This will be a chunky play, which will mean the whole... Oh, look at that. I intend to do at least most of this game. And any injuries sustained during your capture have been designated as non-life-threatening. Remaining journey time is estimated at 16 hours. If you are experiencing severe nausea... The subtitles made that look like if you need to relieve yourself, God damn you. This is, of course, a rather sci-fi take on Journey to the West, the old Chinese book starring Sun Wukong, the monkey. Which British people will remember most from the show Monkey. Monkey, of course, being a show that was originally made in Asia and was then redubbed when it was brought to Britain in like the 80s. Very racistly redubbed. But the kind of charming racism, not the bad racism. It was simpler times back then. This is Monkey, the Ninja Theory's idea of Monkey. Played by Andy Serkis, who, you know, I think we all could agree he does not get enough credit, does Andy Serkis? Lovely stuff. Now, of course, I'm playing the PC version of this, and it's a PC version of a Namco Bandai game. So, excuse me. Had a nasty cough there. It's a PC version of a Namco Bandai game, which means I'm not expecting the best port. In fact, the visuals are a little skippy. I'm only really set up for PC capture at the moment. Otherwise, I would have done the PS3 version. But it's probably still pretty good. Alert. Hull breach. Alert. Hull breach. One thing I loved about this was Chris Carter in Destructoid was calling this a poor man's Uncharted. But I much prefer this one. Like, the environmental stuff is less puzzly, but there's just this beautiful flow to it that makes it more satisfying to me than, you know, your ponderous, oh, I've got to slowly climb up a wall type of game.
Alert.
very explosive beginning, as you can see. God damn visuals. So there, as you can see, like, it's not like you're going from brick to brick trying to find where to go. Press A while standing near a thing. Where are we? This way? Oh no, there we are. Sorry, it's glowing. Look, very fast-paced. It's like, I like all climby stuff like your Prince of Persia's and your Uncharted's to a lesser degree. But the fluidity of movement here is just gorgeous. I mean, really, just the speed of it, some people are like, oh, well, it's a lot more on rails or automatic. To me, it just cuts out the fucking middle, man. It's not really much different from what you're doing in other games where there's lots of climbing. It's just not wasting your time.
Gotta get the weapons back.
Yeah, we're gonna get some weapons.
Where's my stuff? The stuff. Where's my gear? Stuff you took away from me.
I can't talk to you, it's against the rules.
God, Andy Serkis is talented, isn't he?
Slave 6B58 is assisting escaping prisoner. Level 1 in fraction.
Whether he's using his own accent or putting one on, like, I could listen to Serkis all day. That's what we call foreshadowing. Yeah, let's do this.
Escape pod 8 launched. 7 pods remaining.
Love the animation in this game as well.
My ride. At least I can get my gear back.
Now we got our fisty punch.
Damn.
And our sticky whack. And he's pleased with himself.
Okay. Let's deal with that mech.
Damn right, we're gonna deal with that mech. So you bash the X button on the controller. I'm using a controller. Again, it's Namco Bandai. I really am assuming that trying to consoleize it as much as possible is the best. Oh, there we go. That wasn't that freezing. It was just waiting for me to do it before it would let me continue. They always break the flow for me that when the tutorials do that.
At least they're not active.
Slow walk. Have a little look at the robots.
Activating combat.
Oh, he spoke too soon. Ha ha ha. Oh. Block. Okay, you see in the tutorial, that's all pretty straightforward. They really didn't... Again, it's the same with the climbing stuff. They made everything very sort of flowy, very fluid. It's not all complex combos and, like, deep combat system. It's designed entirely to be, you know, you just dive right in and dive right out again. And I like that. I can respect that. This is the wrong way, isn't it? Yeah. I knew it was. I just, for some reason, I had to check. There's even a fucking arrow. Woo! Woo! There we go. Sometimes even when I know I'm going the wrong way, I've got to just commit and do it anyway. Like that. Wide attack. It's pretty straightforward. Hold for a stun. Oh. Whoa! How's that? Come over here. Bash! Okay, well now we go the green way, we know that. Chow, chow. The outside scene's just, so much, so much blue and green. Oh. He probably said, friend, you mother friend. And don't get me wrong, it's not just that they're pretty graphics. Pretty graphics don't mean a lot to me. It's all about the design. Art direction trumps graphical prowess every single fucking time. It's the design, just the color. Look at the color. That is legit. Oh, look at how it looks. Take this over a dozen photorealistic, you know, quote-unquote, better-looking games. You know, you can do your facial motion capture. Takes no artistic talent to capture the motion of someone's existing face. Designing a guy like this, with his own unique original look and a unique art style, that's talent. I was saying yesterday, like, money can get you graphics. Money can't get you a beautiful looking game. Talent gets you a beautiful looking game. This way, I think, yes. Yes. Up the handy hold. So let me just say that again in something easily more quotable and soundbitey. Money gets you good graphics. Talent gets you a good looking game. So again, just the lovely, fast-paced flow of this. He's not slowly edging along ledges and up poles. Like, he's a monkey guy. You know, he leaps, he scampers, clambers, skitters. And again, it's just beautiful animation is selling that. That's the old statue of Dribbly. I remember when this whole section came out as a demo on the PlayStation Network. It was very much taken with it. Okay. The frame rate's dropped. Because we're in cutscene mode. Hate badly compressed cutscenes and stuff on PC versions. Always the same, always happens. Oh, we're back to normal. Excuse me for coughing, I'm trying to do it away from the microphone. Shit. I'm always... Oh, shit. Hold on. Sorry about that. Again, I was after a cheeky coffee while that cutscene had been playing. Up here for thrilling times. Whoa, get up there. Barum, barum.
Escape pod 2 launched.
Yep, we know where we're going. Oh, shit. Oh, no, I've got to go up there. I'm going. Don't call me an idiot. 20 seconds. There we go. There we go. Oh, that reckless monkey. And we are about to see the most gorgeous looking post-apocalypse world you could ever hope to see. This isn't a world in which everything's just rubble and ash. They designed it to show, like, you know, nature reclaiming everything after people had gone away. It's a strong, very strong art style this game has. It's something else. And that was the intro. That's a strong intro, I believe. As we load up. Chapter 2, The Old City. God, that mouse curse wasn't there that whole time, was it? I hope not. No, it went away. It's a deer. The American flag. God bless the United States of America, please. You know, it's about time we did. It's about time we had some patriotism in the country. He says while living in a state where, there's a flag on every other house just to remind you that you're living in the United States. It's good that people do put American flags outside their houses. I tend to forget where I'm living. Ba ba ba.
Oh God, my head feels like it's ripped open.
I love Andy Serkis.
What? The slave headband. The one I fit on you.
Nah, Trip, of course. Played by... this on me. Person who is always doing voices in all of the games.
Or I'm gonna rip your head off.
Along with the other people who are always doing voices in all of the games.
No.
I always forget their names. Liam O'Brien, I know the name of.
Yes!
Troy Baker, of course. Steve Bloom. Yuri Lowenthal, one of my favourites. A whole bunch of others. Jennifer Hale.
Move away from me.
Tara Strong. I'm just naming voice actors for no reason.
Oh. What the hell are you doing?
I hacked a slave headband so it could be activated by my voice commands.
Which again is similar to what happened in Journey to the West. It's all there.
My heart stops beating for any reason. The headband will discharge a lethal dose.
Classic Gambit. Classic.
If I die, you die.
Oh.
So she's really endearing herself to him.
Why?
I need your help. I come from a wind farm community. It's about 300 miles from here. I'll never make it on my own. If slavers don't get me, mechs will. Deal. Get me back to my home and you can go back to yours.
It's an interesting take on the, you know, tried and tested escort thing, you know. Oh, the weak woman needs to be protected kind of shit. Because it's not just that she needs to be protected, like, she's dicked you over and has the power. It's a very unique take on it, I think. It's not like you've taken pity on her and are swooping in heroic. You are very much...
Stay with me.
Lovely. You know, she's very much forcing you into this. I like those kinds of unique dynamics.
I've hacked the headband to give you visual feedback. It's past patched into your shield system and my biometrics.
It's always nice when a game explains why you've got a HUD.
My goddamn head.
It is. We have a continuous audio link now.
Great.
You got pretty beat up.
Yeah, so don't let her catch you wanking.
Shall we keep going?
Yeah, it's gonna be great.
I don't think that's the way out.
I don't think you're the way out. No, it looks like it's over here.
Who are all these people?
Who cares?
This must have been some kind of gathering point.
They gathered at this point. That's the point of the gathering point. Yep. Yeah, I've seen it enough. I just want to go over to the thing.
Is this the way out?
Maybe.
This must be a drawbridge.
Must be to keep Max out.
There are some controls here. The other side is blocked. Can you get around and clear it?
Oh, Muggins here. I have to do all the work.
Be careful.
Hold LB at any time to look at your captor. And like that, I like that as well. Like, it's not your ward or anything. You're the hostage in the situation.
Keep your voice down. They could be close.
What are we gonna do?
Not make too much noise.
There we go. Stylishly done. Gaboom!
Shit. Keep out of the way. Let me deal with this.
Where are they? Ah, here they come. Yeah, we're gonna smash them up. Whoa! Oops. Pressed the wrong button to fucking dodge because I'm a goon. There we go. That's more like it. Smash him up.
It's all clear. Get over here.
Coming.
Hey, get your ass over here.
We could get out through here.
Yeah, we're gonna get out through here. It's gonna be fantastic. Lovely stuff. Ah, just look at it. Gonna health up. Deer. Having a bit of a run.
Do you think you could tell me what the plan is?
Look at that. Prettiest apocalypse ever.
To get you home as fast as possible so that you can take this thing off my head and I can break your neck.
I meant...
Yeah, I know what you meant. See that smoke over there? That's where the slave ship came down. First thing we're gonna do is head for that. Hoping my ride survived the crash.
What's your ride?
It's the only way I know how to cover 300 miles. Two wheels and an engine.
Look at this place.
He means a bike.
There's thousands of people living here.
More.
I know why I said that.
Thousands?
Maybe.
Give me that.
So sad.
It's a, not long after 6 in the morning over here, as I record this. I'm having to record everything early. I've got to do Gymquisition for the Escapist really quickly. I did a lot of it last night, but I've got to finish that up. Yeah, because Batman Arkham Origins is coming today. They decided to withhold review copies for most of the game reviewers, which is always a sign of confidence in a game. And that means my entire Friday is shot, because as soon as that gets here, I've got to blast through that. Don't like when that happens. Let's just have a little... Oh, I was trying to take in the sights. That is one issue with this game. It does at least initially, wrest control away from you quite a bit, just to show things that you don't need to see or be introduced to.
When I give you the signal, you get back, okay?
No, there's no limit. That's what she should have said.
I gotta find a way to take him out.
Yeah, I'm gonna. It's gonna be great. There we go. Bash it up. I just want to look at the scenery. Oh, we're going to smash these things to bits. There we go. There ain't nothing. Bloody hell. Hey, I pressed the block! There we go. Smash him to bits! Oh, we know now.
If we're gonna get through this, then when I ask you to do something, you need to do it immediately.
Okay. I understand.
It's just a really interesting dynamic they have. Like, she... I find her an interesting character. For all of the, like... There is a stereotypical sort of helplessness to her, but... It's the way they present it. It's all... It's in how you tell them. I think is the important thing there. You can do established ideas and tropes. You've just gotta... not be an idiot about them. Le command. Push L.
Let's go.
There you go.
Okay.
Kaboom. God, the reds as well. The reds with the greens. Lovely contrast. I don't know why more games this generation...
We can go this way.
...didn't look like this. You know? I've always thought it ironic that in the high-definition generation, games went all photorealistic and grey and dismal-looking. Because that doesn't show off HD graphics. Games like this does. Do, rather. This is why I've always said that Viva Pinata is one of the best-looking games this generation. Yeah, it's not got photorealistic graphics and facial motion capture, but it's got bright, stark, contrasting colours. And that's what shows up on an HD TV. You know, this... Something like this makes so much better use of HD than something like Killzone, because they've been making those more pretty. You know, your Call of Duties, your Medals of Honor. Or at least Killzone 2, I guess, was very sort of black on black and grey on grey. Like, it just doesn't show off HD as well. Contrast. Bold colours. That's what does it. You can tell I'm this game excites me. I'll get across and draw their attention. It's tragic this game did not do very well. Then again, I think it's tragic that all of Ninja Theory's games to date have not done that fantastically. Like, I know people hated the Devil May Cry. There we go. Easy.
Hey! This way! Hey! Hey! Turn! Hey!
But, yeah, like, people had problems with DMC, the Devil May Cry, to the point where some people got very creepy about it. Just a creepy hate. They couldn't just dislike it and let it be. They had to make all sorts of weird accusations, even lie about the game to try and stop people buying it. There was weird, horrible stuff going on. But at the very least, I was happy for Ninja Theory. Oh yeah, she's gotta do it. I'm an idiot! I wasn't listening! I was too busy rambling about Devil May Cry. It's alright, we can rush through that again, we know what we're doing. But yeah, I was happy for them getting a big property like Devil May Cry. I thought, well, finally, they'll get a chance to work on something that's going to be successful. And then that game didn't do very well, like, at all. Which, you know, fair enough, the market spoke. That's not the Devil May Cry they wanted. Capcom will be able to cynically make the next Devil May Cry a return to form, which will sucker everyone in. They'll love that. And that's fine. It's like, I'm not... I loved DMC. I honestly did. I think it's a shame it didn't sell very well. But you gotta say, fair enough, they didn't want it. And I guess fair enough they didn't want... Oh, God. See, again, I'm just too busy rambling. Because I know a lot of people... in comments and stuff to other videos I've done, have asked for me to be more analytical and critical, since that is my day job, is to criticize games, so I'm not just playing them and cracking wise, which there are lots of Let's Players that do that. They're very good at it. I'm trying to, you know, lend what little bit of difference I can bring to the table.
We're not in the clear yet. There's the way out.
But anyway, yes, I just thought it was very sad. This game didn't do as well as it could have. I wish it did. Right. Shitty robots. Yeah, you take him out. Take him out to dinner. Pain dinner. Yeah, we'll, oh shit! Oh god, oh god! She got it back. Oh, look, someone's in the corners playing Batman Arkham Origins. See, even as a fucking reviewer, I'd have been better off just buying it. I'm not gonna, on principle.
Okay, fully charged.
I don't need it. I'm gonna bash him up! Ah! Hell yeah. Yep, she's doing alright. Yeah, alright, I don't need to look at her the whole time. I know what she's doing. There we go. Yep. Over we go! Oops. What am I doing? Oh yeah, there's the greppy grippies. I'll have that. And that. Because those orbs do something. Lovely stuff. Oops. His movement was a little bit stiff there. I'll have that. If and you don't mind. I'll have a lift of this and all. There are black borders on the side of this on my screen. I'm gonna have to mess with the resolution and shit when I edit this. Pain in the ass. Well, was there a thing? No.
Look at this tree. It must be hundreds of years old.
Hundreds, mate. Where are we? What have you done? Oh, there. That's what I want to be. Come here. Collecty things. They make your games more interesting. Allegedly. Yeah, I will make cynical, sarcastic, shitty little remarks even about games I love. Because I'm confident and secure in the things I like, that's why. You get people, they won't hear a bad word said against their favourite games. I'll make fun out of every game I love. I'm a big Dynasty Warriors fan. And I realise that's funny. I'll exploit it for comedy. I adore Metal Gear Solid, but I remember I once did an article, The 10 Golden Rules of Metal Gear Solid, and it was just making fun of Metal Gear Solid mercilessly. And people were like, oh, he's trolling, oh, he hates the game, why is he being a hater? And it's like, you fucking idiot. In order to really successfully make fun of something, you've got to know it pretty damn well.
What are you talking about?
I'm not commanding you. I'm asking you.
What fucking Steam putting my friend's thing back on? I don't care that Sparky is playing Killing Floor. I added all these people because they...
What about that ladder? If you lift me up, maybe I can...
Because I try and be a man of the people, and I get punished. Toss her around. Ba-doom.
So, you want me to catch one of these dragonflies?
It might be difficult.
Climb it up.
And they're quick. There's one. Right there. I'll put it on your display. It's right over there. It's just...
I just gotta chase it around. Ain't no problem.
Blind. God damn it, stay still.
Oh god, this game is gorgeous. And again, it's the animation that makes it so gorgeous, and the colour. I will keep talking about that, because I believe so strongly in that. I was looking at Killzone Shadowfall, which is coming out, obviously, with the PS4. And they were showing all these GIFs, showing off the how pretty the graphics look. And everyone was drooling over the lightning effects and everything. But to me, it was the colour scheme, the design of the architecture. It was the... Let's just pop in here and get these. It was the stark blacks and the reds, the way the reds contrasted against the black for the Hellgarn environments. I love the design of the Hellgast and all their sort of architecture and culture. And the way they contrast with the Vecton culture, because they're sharing a planet now. That's me getting very geeky on Killzone stuff. And the Vecton area is very blue and green and stuff. So it's just this gorgeous contrast, which again is what I think really made HD graphics, or what really exploit HD graphics to their fullest. So we got our dragonfly. I love that, just the way
all the time as a kid.
The way the machines have taken over nature as well. To the point where you've got the mechanical dragonflies.
Some simple sensors to help them sniff out energy sources. They're pretty basic, but for our purposes. I'll do the trick.
I want one of those.
Meh.
Keep still.
Is that really comfortable? Like, I know it's supposed to be a dragonfly. It's still a robot. That's got to be heavy. I'm surprised it didn't just, like, yank her ear off.
It's now set up to send a live relay to your headband. It has a camera setting and a sensor setting.
So?
Try it out. Follow me.
Yeah, I'm doing it, aren't I? Mechs. Oh, no mechs. I didn't see the no for a second. I thought it was mechs doing graffiti of themselves. Just showing off. Yeah, we're mechs. It's brilliant. We're having a great time, aren't we?
You should be able to see the mines on your headband display.
I don't want to go near those mines. They're a pain in the ass.
It's pretty cool, huh?
Yeah. Yeah, it's pretty cool.
Okay.
Can you take me through the mines? I can't see where they are.
Oh, yeah, I have to pick up Trip. Tripitaka, I believe, is the full name in the Journey to the West. Along with Pigsy, who we'll see later. And, I don't think there's a Santee analogue in this, is there? I can't remember. Sandy in Journey to the West being a fish-based guy, while Pigsy, of course, is, you know, self-explanatory. Look at it! Look how gorgeous that is. God! I will take that over any... Oh, it looks just like Ellen Page. Look how original my art direction is. It's someone you've already seen in real life. This is talent. This is art. This loading screen is not art and talent. Oh, we're done. You can get off my back.
That was easy.
I've heard of having a monkey on your back, but not you on a... Oh, so pretty.
Wait a minute. Something's not...
Damn right, something's not right here.
Should do another scan.
Scan that sucker.
You got a problem. There are mines everywhere. Let's head for that building.
Yeah, the dragonfly has no real value other than an excuse to put things on the map that you can see. Come here. Come here. Come here. Come here. Pow, pow. You cannot clamber with her. Yep. She can't clamber with you, which is the annoyance. What was the deal with that? Come here. So we got stuffs. Similarly, it's why I've always liked the look of the current generation Sonic the Hedgehog games, even if I've never loved the all of the games themselves. Hedgehog Engine is a beautiful graphics engine. Just utterly lovely. I don't want to clamber with her. Come here.
Throw me up to that ledge. I'll look for a way through.
I can do that. We just gotta work out a way to the ledge. That's the ledge. That's all spare free areas. Yeah, I know. It's all good. We cool, brah, we cool. There we go, see? You just gotta jump on the cars. I just needed to remember that I could do that with her on my back. Be aware of the boundaries.
I can get across up here.
Do it.
Okay. Okay, I'll find another way.
Give me that. Oh. Hang on. There we go. Smashed him up. I smash good.
I'm fine.
I'll have this and all. You mine? As he lightly jogs. There we go. Now what? Do. Bow bow.
Can you help me?
So much trouble. This is just a saga now. It's one way of doing it.
Thanks.
Simple enough.
Too close.
It was fine.
There's a sentry turret over there.
Of course there is.
We won't be able to get past.
I'm gonna scan.
You don't need to. Like, I know where it is. It's there.
Structural weakness. If you could get close, you might be able to knock that down and crush it.
I can do that. I can do that 15 times. There we go.
I need another scan.
I mean, you could do that without taking gameplay away. That's the thing. We can just assume and take it as read that the dragonfly is doing its dragonfly thing. Where's the fun in sneaking past them? Screw sneaking past him. I smash him up! I want my little glowing orbs. I love these glowing orbs and all. I do like how the strap on his back looks like a monkey tail. Yeah, sneaking's one way of doing it. much prefer to smash them up. Oh, you blocky bastard. Yeah, that's what I thought. Yeah, that's what you get. We've all learned a lesson today. It's valuable. I'll just get that as well, for what it's worth. Boom, boom, boom.
They spotted me, but I'm through.
They didn't spot me. I wanted that. Oop. Just wanna, there we are, smash, smash, smash. What do you think I'm doing?
Okay, made it. Plasma cells. Now we're in business. I hope this thing still works.
There we go. And, oh, there. That's one way of doing it.
Help me! They're coming! Quick, do something!
I'll do something. I'll go bash him up. Fucking hell. There we go. Bash him up! Everything's hunky-dory. Poor choice of words. Trip. Okay, let's just be real subtle like. Let's just nudge him through.
Hurry up.
It'll be fine. God, I gotta remember to take those bloody Steam notifications off. Because I'm in the beta, so every time I, you know, I've gotta restart the fucking Steam every 3 minutes with some new update. And then I forget to set my status to offline so I get all the updates and stuff. I got to set my stuff to offline anyway, because every time I start a game, I'll get a note from someone who is like, oh, he's playing a game. Now's the perfect time for a chat. You know. But anyway, that's a good... Shush.
My name is
Trip. I'll just let them talk. Yeah.
I mean, pretty much... always. People call me Trip. How about you?
I don't have a name.
Oh, God. I just want him to stop talking. I want to end this section here.
Everyone.
Well, what did your parents call you?
They were killed in a mech attack when I was a kid. I grew up in the wilds.
Do you know what? They'll just replay that next time we start. That's Enslaved, Odyssey to the West. That is now available on Steam and PlayStation Network. Gorgeous game, as you could see, hopefully, if you agree with me. Beautiful thing. I've been waiting to get and play this again. So, yeah, this is going to be a new chunky play, which means I will be playing more of this defo. There will be a part two when I get round to it. Maybe after the weekend. Maybe over the weekend. I don't know. I don't know how these things go. But if you like the video, then let me know and make me feel good in my heart and myself. K-Pax, I don't care that you're playing the Stanley Parable. I'm sorry, but Stanley Parable is fucking good. I've not done a video of that because I've, I don't know. It's one I just want people to go play. Go play Stanley Parable after you've, you know, watched this video and then told all your friends to fucking watch it and told them all that they've got to subscribe to my shit. So anyway, I'm Jim. Thank God for me. And I'll see you next time.